Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. This video discusses how C13 NMR spectroscopy is often used in organic synthesis. On the surface, C13 NMR may not seem very useful. I think it has two main disadvantages to proton NMR. C13 has much longer acquisition times, often about an hour to get a spectrum, possibly much longer, versus 10 minutes for a proton spectrum. Keep in mind that NMR spectrometers are very expensive, and when you are running your 1-hour C13 spectrum, nobody else can use the spectrometer. So time on the spectrometer is a limited resource and valuable. Furthermore, because of lower signal-to-noise in a C13 spectrum, C13 NMR is often not very good for identifying or quantifying impurities. With these issues, why is C13 NMR still useful? Let's list some valuable uses for C13 NMR. First, information from a C13 spectrum provides additional confirmation of structure beyond a proton spectrum. So the structural information is complementary and not redundant between the two methods. An example is for quaternary carbons. In a proton NMR spectrum, most carbons are represented indirectly in the spectrum because you can see the hydrogens that are attached to carbons in the molecule. Quaternary carbons have no attached hydrogens, so quaternary carbons are hard to infer through a proton spectrum alone. With a C13 spectrum, you have direct evidence of all your carbons, including the quaternary signals. A second reason supporting the need for C13 NMR is that C13 can be more sensitive for differentiating isomers than proton NMR. On the left are two simulated proton spectra from nmrdb.org for two isomers, specifically two diastereomers. Based on these simulated spectra, these isomers would be hard to distinguish by proton NMR. For example, if you made the top isomer and someone asked, "How can you tell you didn't make the bottom isomer?" then you might have a hard time answering that question. I mean, the spectra are nearly identical. Now let's look at simulated C13 spectra. These are much more different. Sometimes by looking at the carbon nuclei instead of hydrogen nuclei, one can find data that more clearly distinguish one compound from another. My last reason for why people acquire C13 NMR spectra is a practical one. If an organic chemist makes a new molecule that nobody has ever synthesized, and this happens often in the world of research, then the chemist must gather different types of characterization data as evidence to confirm the structure of the molecule. On the screen are the requirements from an organic chemistry journal, Organic Chemistry Frontiers. A C13 NMR spectrum is one of the required types of characterization data. So, while you may be able to rely on proton NMR to analyze new structures as you work in lab day to day, for publication, new compounds will need to be characterized by C13 as well. So based on my experience as a synthetic chemist, maybe 95% or more of NMR spectra you obtain will be proton spectra, because often you are making compounds that are known in the literature or you have already made yourself. You just need a quick proton spectrum to confirm a structure or its purity. The remaining 5% of all spectra will include methods like C13 NMR for advanced characterization or publication needs. We've now reviewed some reasons why C13 NMR is important for compound characterization. Please leave a like or subscribe. If you have a question or comment, please use the comments section. Take care.